But when he approached the TV executives, their opinion was obvious. So he realized the only way to reappear on the video screens of Chicago was to break into the TV signal. And using state-of-the-art equipment and several 9-volt batteries, he invaded the airwaves of Fox 32. True, it wasn't easy. There were occasional equipment problems and other minor setbacks. But now, once every week, much to the dismay of station management, Rich Koz opens the video viaduct that leads to the Koz Zone.
Oh, welcome to another edition of the Koz Zone, where this week we plunge into deepest, darkest Africa in search of King Solomon's treasure.
Oh, it's King Solomon's mines?
No, that's a famous 1950 Stuart Granger movie involving diamonds. This is King Solomon's Treasure, which is a search for gold starring former TV spies David Mann from Uncle McCallum and Patrick the Avengers McNee. And the lovely Britt Eklund, who I don't think even King Solomon mind.
Oh, then it is King Solomon's mind.
No, it's King Solomon's treasure.
That movie's yours?
Yes, King Solomon's mine.
Oh, King Solomon's mine.
It's not King Solomon's mine, it's King Solomon's treasure. Treasure, I hope you don't mind.
No, but King Solomon would.
Why should King Solomon mind?
Oh, King Solomon's mind?
No!
A mind is a terrible thing to waste.
It's treasure! Ow!
What the devil's going on here? Who are these people? Are they members? I don't know what the damn club's coming to. Can't even have a little snooze now.
We'll return to Dance Fever in a moment, but first, it's... it's the Koz phone. Yes, hello.
Hey, my friend. Need any carpentry done? I'm a master carpenter. I hammer like lightning.
Oh, hammer like lightning. Does that mean you're fast?
Nope. I never hit the same place twice.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Anyway, I'm watching this movie, and I figured that it's... Excuse me. Hello?
Koz, I'm going outside, and it's chilly. You got a spare pair of gloves? I always forget
mine. Why not tie a string around your finger?
Actually, I think gloves would be warmer.
Okay, fine. Listen, I think that this... There's a gas leak in here. Excuse me, it's the phone. Yellow.
Woohoo, Koz. Oh, I'm feeling great. I never realized getting fit was so easy. Oh, my doctor told me I had to play 36 holes every week.
Play 36 holes every week? And you're doing it?
Yeah, I took up the harmonica. Woohoo. Oh.
Back to King Solomon's treasure right after these messages, ma'am. Give me a donut.
GHIJKLMNOPQRS.
Just in time for tea.
When I catch the leopard man, you'll see.
No, not Letterman. Again. And I'm sure...
Hey, Richie, what's that native's name?
Oh, the native's name. It's Umslopagus.
Oh!
It's Umslopagus. Ask a baby not to cry. It's just Umslopagus. Boo.
That old car is worth money. Not to you, to me. I'm sorry. Vic sorry. And I want to take your car. Call Vic Sorry Auto Snatchers today. I'll take your car away and get cash for it. You'll be rid of a costly gas-guzzling vehicle, free of license fees and repair bills. And no more worries about finding parking space. Plus, you could get cash from your insurance company on a stolen auto claim. Or, thinking of fixing up your car with used parts? Why bother? Parts cost money and you might get dirty or something. Let Vic Sorry Auto Snatchers take it away. I take all cars, all models, all the risks. You get money from your insurance company. Maybe. Call me. I'd be glad to give you a quote. Here's one now. Ask not what you can do for your country. I think that's Kennedy. Yeah, George Kennedy. Big Sorry Auto Snatches, located right near O'Hare, usually Lot C, the area where the light's not working too well. Just leave your window cracked or a door unlocked. I also fill trunks.
Back to the King Solomon's Treasure where... Oh, look, Gene and Roger. There's a guy outside who's got incriminating photos of Dixie Watley and Rex Reed in a compromising position. You two wouldn't be interested in...
No need for confusion about your consommé. Time again for the missing link between dinner and the emergency ward, the feudal gourmet.
I don't think he's moving. Did somebody order this? See if anybody wants to eat this. We don't want to waste it. I think he's gone belly up. Oh, happy to be with you again. Thanks to a sponsorship grant, appropriately enough, from Alka-Seltzer. They did have to battle it out with Liquid Plumber, of course. But we're glad to be here with you again. Tonight we're going to talk about foreign dishes. Now, foreign dishes are very popular ever since the days of Gina Lola Brigida. But seriously, people are crazy about food cooked in a foreign manner. And believe me, I cook stuff in a manner that's foreign to just about anything you've ever seen. Speaking of seen... Have you seen my garlic press? It's just lovely. It's okay, fine. Let's get on to tonight's recipe. It's a favorite taste treat of France. Yes, France. The name is French, and literal English translation is not available. But the French call this delectable culinary delight les leftovers. Les leftovers, you see? And here's how we do it. We begin with a nice mixing bowl like this, and you add a little bit of French dressing. Naughty boy, you should wait until the French finish dressing. We add some of that there. Mmm, what a bouquet. Then we take a little mayonnaise, just a touch of it. Oh, this is good stiff mayonnaise. That's the best kind to use. Well, we don't want to use too much. There we go. That's good. Now, we get a touch of garlic, and whenever you use garlic, you know what you've got to have here. The famous garlic press. We just put it in there and... Oh, nearly took a finger off there. Mmm, that's good. Next, we use just a soupçon of ketchup. Soupçon is French for a whole lot. Let's... Oh, these things have been here a while. There it is. Oh, that's lovely. That's just enough, I think. Now we use 1 pound of the traditional French hardening ingredient. And that, of course, is... Plaster of Paris. We just liberally apply a little bit of this here. We don't want to add too much, just a touch. That's good. And it often helps to thin it just a little bit so it doesn't thicken too quickly. We just use a little water here. Excuse me, Mr. Claus. There we go. That's lovely. Oh, I've lost my... Well, here it is, yes. Now, we don't want it to thicken too quickly, though, so we try to mix it so nicely. You see? That's the way that works. Now, next we throw in a few spare snails that are around. Pre-used ones are usually best. And we add a quart of French perfume or toilet water, if you will. And I don't think you will. There we go. That's in there. Oh, that's lovely. And if handy, you can mix in 4 baseballs. Or if baseballs are out of season, you can put in 4 basketballs. Garlic press? Okay, mix it all together, just as I've done here. I can't seem to find my mixing implement. Here, I'll use this. And you mix it in this, and then you fry it in a large pan, just for the amount of time it takes to sing Dominique, Nique, Nique, Nique. That assures you it'll be French fried. Okay, so once it's fried, you season it with some salt and some pepper, and you strain it through an old pair of Brigitte Bardot's pantyhose, and most importantly, you serve it with 1 French onion.
How can you tell it's a French onion?
Very simple. You check its passport. Its passport. See, look, a garlic press. Oh, take it off. Oh. Mr. Claus, wakey, wakey.
King Solomon's Treasure after these messages. Ooh, the blood is rushing to my ear.
Treasure, as we take a look at today's bargain jewelry deal on the Home Schlocking Club. It's cubic zirconium gold at a price that won't scare you away. Leg special. Okay, it's time once again to play this game that you folks out there just keep clamoring for. It's win, lose, or say uncle in honor of our movie's star, David McCallum, who was Ilya Kuryakin. Look, he always used to talk into his pen. I can do the same thing, except... I'll get ink up my nose with this thing. Okay, all you have to do is guess the name of the Fox 32 show that I'm going to sketch the clues for right now. You can begin guessing right
Now, okay, look carefully at this.
It's a buzzsaw, it's motor eaters, it's chew tobacco, it's
spectacles.
It's a man.
Don't make a spectacle of yourself.
Oh, it's a guy, it's two guys.
It's two.
No, it's two.
What about
two ugly guys?
No.
I got it. They're cousins, identical cousins.
Something identical, you're getting the right idea. Okay, that's that. Ready? Okay, now watch this one.
Oh, it's styling move.
Wombat.
It's
the moon.
No, no.
It's
no, no. No,
it's an overdue library book.
Pudgy.
It's, no, oh, it's the moon with the crutch.
It's no.
It's the moon in a turtleneck.
No.
He's giving us a moon.
Thing right here.
Yeah. No.
Okay, ready? Here we go.
Bert Convy. Bert Convy.
It's a flamingo.
A heartbreak. Psoriasis?
It's an elbow.
No.
It's an elbow macaroni.
It's the top 40. Let me get a Morgana. How about her? She's wild, isn't she? No.
I can't read.
You don't. You make a stupid guess.
Ooh, it's a babe. Whoa.
No, wait. Wait, look,
garden hose?
It's a star on a stick.
A Buick Riviera.
The Twizzle?
No.
Ooh,
white one.
I'm getting sick.
That's what we want right there. Okay, that.
That's primer.
Okay, now watch this carefully. All right?
No, it's uncomfortable earwax buildup.
It's cheesy to pay.
It's one of those first two guys.
No, but it's not so much who it is, but what he's doing here. Look.
He's got a hot foot.
John Phillips Lewis.
No.
Oh, he's killing roaches.
No.
He's leaping.
What are these? I don't know. Ready? This. Okay.
I had no idea.
Here, take a look at this
BLT, McDLT.
Oh, wait a minute. It's a rotary lawnmower.
A shoe sale.
Lizard.
It's George the Animal Steel.
It's a lizard with a hernia.
It's chewed
tobacco.
No, he's burping.
It's a man. A woman.
There it goes. See? Right there.
What is he saying? Okay, let's sum this up now so you get the idea. It's one of these guys.
A hairbrush?
This. This.
It's a softball bat.
These.
It's pneumo pantyhose
with
no bind top.
He says.
Broken steel.
You have any idea what it is?
The Super Mario Brothers.
No.
The stinking Mario Brothers.
No.
What do you think?
I know what it is, and you'll find out in just a moment.
Stinking
Mario.
220 wiring. Denture adhesive.
No.
Bert Convy. Bert Convy.
It's a flamingo.
So Frank found.
Yes, the correct answer to our win, lose, or say uncle puzzle. It was a little tough in certain parts and a little easy in some parts, but let's reveal it here. First of all, these two guys are twins, so one of them would be a twin. You get that? And here, this is a golf ball, and it's on a T. This is like a fairy princess, and she's got a wand in her hand. There you go. So far you've got twin T wand. These things that this guy is doing here, he's doing some jumps. And finally, what is it that the wee birdie says here? He says tweet.
Tweet.
Could say chirp, but that wouldn't make sense. So all together we've got twin T wand jumps tweet. Twin T wand jumps tweet. 21 jumps tweet. So the answer is.
Goodness gracious, it's the reporters.
No.
Maury Povich?
No. Oh,
how about Robin Brantley?
Not
21 jumps tweet.
No, never mind.
That's so cute.
Watch some commercials, won't you? Solomon's Treasure, as we salute the Cubs for a valiant effort. Too bad Popeye Zimmer ended up. Up the creek without a paddle. No.
Oh, Brit! She's got true grit!
Yes, well, I'm sure a lot of you kids are just tuning in after having watched Saturday Night Live. You know, a lot of your fellow kids not only know that Saturday Night Live just isn't as good anymore, but also that it could do them more harm than good. Here's what some kids feel happens to them if they happen to tune in Saturday Night Live instead of the Koz Zone.
You just don't feel in control.
You know you did something stupid, but you don't remember what.
It just makes you lazy.
You forget things. You really do.
It's kind of scary, and you really feel alone.
See, kids, don't make that same mistake. Just say no to pump you up.
This public service message sponsored by people who will pay kids to say anything.
To King Solomon's Treasure after these messages. I'm up past my bedtime.
at the prison lunch program set up for Jim Baker. Oh, sorry. I thought this was Britt Eklund's room. Yeah, well, anyway, it's time for you to get your paper and pencil ready, and your Polaroids, of course, because it's mail call time in the Koz Zone. Don't mind me, I'll just stay here and look around. Mail call here in the Koz Zone. As you can see, we've received so many of your photos and kitchen magnets and such, but if you haven't sent us one yet, what are you waiting for? Just send it to us here. And the address is, as always, as you take a look at this, the Koz Zone, care of WFLD Fox 32, 205 North Michigan Avenue, Chicago.
Berwyn.
No, Chicago, Illinois, 60601. And please make sure that you mark it, attention, Rich Koz. We've received so many fine kitchen magnets. And before I forget, I do want to thank everybody who came out to the big Hobie Parade in, guess where?
Berwyn.
That's right, Berwyn last week. It was nice to see everybody. We're glad that you're watching the show and that you enjoyed Marnie last week. But then again, who didn't? So, you know, once again, if you want to write to us, the address again is the Koz Zone. And that, of course, is care of Fox 32, WFLD, 205 North Michigan Avenue, Chicago.
Berwyn.
I'm getting awfully sick of that. Illinois, 60601. And please make sure that you send us a really good picture. Some of these that are out of focus. We've had to readjust our cameras so many times. And no more dog pictures. I mean it. I'm getting sick of those dog pictures. And I'm not a dog. That rumor's been going around. And please, make sure that you tune me in on the radio. If you just can't get enough of me on TV, and I can't believe there's anybody who's saying that to themselves right now, join me from 5 to 9 a.m. every weekday morning on WCKG 105.9 FM, because I'll be there, and I hope that you will be, too. Although I can't show your picture there. Can I? I don't think so. Take the camera off me. I have nothing left to say. Now the conclusion of King Solomon's treasure. Listen, could somebody look at this handy portable CTA route map for me? I'm just confused by the whole thing.
The man who designed this map was a cartographic charlatan.
There's a film, Marriage Made in Heaven, filmed in both Swaziland and Montreal, eh? For all you hosers. Okay. Listen, tune in next Saturday night at 11 o'clock, because in the Koz Zone, we've got a special movie. It's a genetic experiment that turns into a biohazard, and it turns helpless employees into germ-infected, hatchet-wielding killers. Sounds like a typical day at Fox 32. No, no, no. It's Sam Waterston, Kathleen Quinlan, and Richard Dysart of L.A. Law, starring in Warning Sign. That'll be next Saturday night at 11. We'll close up the Koz Zone now and hope that you'll return.
I showed him.
Showed him what?
Richie, they always said I'd never make it as a professional golfer. But I showed him. I played 36 holes a day. I entered every tournament I could. I never won any. But then, last weekend at the Southern North American Open, held at Sandusky, Ohio, by the way, I collected $100,000. Yeah!
You mean you finally won the tournament?
No! Arnold Palmer accidentally hit me in the head with a 5-iron. Or was it Curtis Strange?
This whole thing is great. See you next week in the Koz Zone.
By the hill and do the next thing that you feel. We were so in phase in a dance all days. We were cool on craze when I, you and everyone we knew could believe, do sharing what was true, I said. That's all day's love.
Good night, everybody.